Welcome to another photo editing video on this channel, in which I'm going to show you how to get from this photo to this photo. And the focus of this video will be color contrast. Let's just start with the base image here. And I only edited this image in Lightroom till now. What you can see is that I had golden light that evening, which bathes the whole scene into this warm color tones. And that's also the problem. Although this looked spectacular when I was there, here on this photo, it looks like a color cast because the whole image is orangey, yellowish, and I need a bit of contrast here. Otherwise, it doesn't look clean in my opinion. So I want to now show you how you can work on color contrast in images where there's not much of it to begin with. So everything, even here, the blues in the sky, because of all the haze here, look yellowish. And to get to this image here, there's quite some work to do. The first step you can do with such an image is you can go back into the raw processing. And I do this now here by duplicating the layer, and then I go to filter, camera raw filter. So it's not really raw processing now because the image was already converted into PSD here, but we can still use the different settings. And one of the settings that helps here and that introduces a lot of contrast and also color contrast is the Dehaze slider here. Let's just bring it to the extreme so you can see what happens. This is obviously a lot too much, but just look at this area here. This now looks blue, while before it was just a very soft blue hidden behind the hazy golden tones here. So I'm going to use this slider and bring it up to about 50 just to get started. Then also let's play around with the clarity a bit. This doesn't do too much to the colors. It mostly adds even more drama to the sky, which I'm not going to need here. So after I've now introduced the first bit of color, also blue tones here, with the Dehaze slider, let's go to the color mixer and use the point color. If you don't see it, you have to switch here to point color. And now I'm going to sample here an area of this blue colors. And you see in this patch here, it's not really blue yet. So what we want to do is now boost the saturation. Let's also play around with the luminance, so make it a little darker. We can also extend the range a bit just to avoid that we get here what you see, those fringes, as we go to the extremes, to make it a little smoother. And then also see if we can change the hue a bit, make it more cyan. And then also in addition to just using Dehaze, we can also add a bit of contrast. So just giving this even more drama. Now let's go back to the effects and see if increasing the Dehaze gives us a bit more color. This all gets very dark here. What we can do is also we can bring up the exposure a bit, open up the shadows, just to avoid that this is getting too dramatic here, and then bring down the highlights. I'm gonna circle back here to the color mixer and also maybe sample up here and this area here. So this color here is a little bit too magenta, so I'll also push it a bit more into the cyan direction to make this blue look more natural. I can also lighten it a bit, but not too much, because otherwise you see fringes appear. Let's extend the range a bit. Now see quickly before and after. So we already improved it quite a bit. I want to once more go up here to the light, see what it does to add contrast or remove contrast. Yeah, it doesn't change too much. Circle back to the effects. Increase the Dehaze a bit more. I think now we have already some good color contrast to start working with. Now I press OK and we're back in Photoshop. Now the first thing you can do now, we can split this set of changes we did to two layers, where we set the blend mode of one layer to color. So it will just affect the color, and we'll set the blend mode of the other one to luminosity. Now, if I deactivate the luminosity layer, you see we have isolated the changes we did mostly by using Dehaze to the color onto a separate layer. And you see here, this just affects the colors, but it doesn't look natural without adding at least a little bit of contrast. So I'm gonna reduce the luminosity opacity, and I might go with something like 80%. Now let's see the before and after, and we're now already a lot closer to where we want to go. Now here in Photoshop, what we can also now do, since by now we already have some blues in the image, we can just use here a use saturation layer. We can click on this finger icon here and then again sample, similar to the point color in Lightroom, but now here in Photoshop it's a bit more flexible because it directly comes with a mask. So for me it's just quicker to use. And now we can shift it a bit into the cyan direction and also extend it here, so that we include a little bit more of those tones around the blues. And I can increase, decrease saturation, make it a little bit lighter. See the before and the after. And now I want to invert the mask, Control I, and just want to affect this area here, because here I like the blue, but up here it was a bit too cyan. Now what we can also do is selective color, the blues, we give it a bit more cyan, remove the yellow, which makes it also bluer, and then we can play around with blacks, so make it darker. Go to the cyans, we do the same, we take out some yellow, we add some cyan, and we can play around here with the black slider. Now we go to the yellows and make them a little bit more reddish to increase this color contrast between the warm tones and the cool tones, before and after. And you see up here, this too much. So let's again just bring in a hue saturation slider and yeah, let's remove some of the saturation up here. Also make it darker. Control I, invert the mask, and with a white brush and like 50%, I'm gonna remove the effect up here a bit. Then I can also bring in a curves layer, adding even more contrast. Selectively, Control I inverts the mask, and again just bring it in selectively in some of the areas. So now we went from this image here to this image already, and this now looks much too dramatic, but what we have is a very nice color contrast. So I want to flatten it down now. Control Alt Shift and E. I can delete those, and now I want to reduce some of this harshness in the sky and also in the foreground. And I'm gonna apply a technique which I showed in another video, which I link below, my best kept Photoshop secret. It goes like this. We duplicate this layer, we go to Image, Adjustments, Brightness and Contrast, and use Legacy. We set the contrast to minus 50. Now we Control I, invert the layer, and Control Shift U, remove the color. Now we set it to soft light, and now this already looks interesting, but what I want to do now as a final step is go to filter, other, high pass. And you can play around with the radius. For me, something between 90 and 110 usually works well. I press OK, and in addition to that, let's bring in a curves layer. Alt click between this high pass layer and the curves layer. Now the curves will just affect the high pass layer. And I want to darken a bit the dark tones, basically a slight S curve. Before and after. And now I'll selectively apply it. Alt click on the mask, so we have a black mask. I'll zoom out a bit, and now I remove some of the micro and medium contrast while also darkening the image. This gives it a much more dreamy look. And you see also how the image now looks, yeah, much more clean, much more clear, because we have a color contrast. And those techniques I now showed you, can repeat them, add on top of them, and refine the colors further. Your creativity is the limit here. And I now don't want to continue repeating all the steps again and again, because this is just fine-tuning, and it's also depending a lot on your personal preference. So the techniques, you've now learned them. Most important, the dehaze, which you can use to bring in color contrast. So basically dehazing the whole image and then splitting the effect into a luminosity and a color layer, where you can then independently control the effect. And then you just work with the HSL and the selective color in Photoshop to further refine the colors, and then finally add a dreamy layer on top to get to this result. And my final result involved a bit more. I removed a bit more of those orangey and magenta colors in the sky. I darkened down the foreground, giving the image a lot more depth. And to achieve this, again, mostly curves in Photoshop, but I also used a bit of Lumina Neo. I have another video on that where I show how to use it for landscape photos. And yeah, that's basically all you need to do here. I hope you liked the video. If so, leave a thumbs up, and yeah, see you on the next one. Bye.